Hey everybody, my break is over. I could use some more time, I'm not gonna lie, but it's time to get back to work. I'm still extremely busy at this point. I wish I could tell you guys that that is all due to airbrushing, but that's just not the case. Life and a lot of other things are getting in the way of what I would rather be doing at this point. I'm still committed to this channel. I'm still committing to creating content to help you guys along in your airbrush journey. So I will continue to do that. A couple things to talk about. My uploads from this point on will happen on Mondays, at least until further notice. Changing the upload schedule from Saturdays to Mondays will just give me a little bit extra time to create better content for you guys based on my current schedule. It may go back to Saturday at some point in the future. We'll just have to wait and see. But for now, beginning next week, my video uploads will happen on Mondays. At the same time, it'll be 6 p.m. Central Standard Time. For this next series of videos, I wanted to talk about freehand shields and stencils. One of the coolest things about the airbrush, in my opinion, is the fact that somebody with very little experience can use other tools along with their airbrush and turn out some really incredible artwork for a very low experience level. What I'm talking about is using other tools, techniques, and methods, whether it's masking techniques, scratching techniques, erasing techniques, stencils, freehand shields, all of those tools combined with the airbrush can help you if you're relatively new or inexperienced in this to still turn out some really nice artwork when you may not have spent the time required to really develop your fundamental control skills when it comes to actually operating the airbrush. So you may not be able to point that airbrush at your canvas and paint anything you want freehand. That's okay. There's a lot of people out there that can't do that. But you can take advantage of those other tools to improve your artwork and speed up the progress when it comes to learning how to use your airbrush and develop those good fundamental skills. In this series of videos, we're going to talk specifically about freehand shields and stencils. I have a really bad habit of using those terms interchangeably, and I'm going to try to break myself from doing that, but I may make some mistakes in these series of videos. A stencil, in my opinion, is an image that has been cut into a substrate that you can use to transfer that image onto your painting surface. So a stencil can help you to map out your design. It can allow you to put in some very sharp lines, and it can allow you to put in some not so sharp lines. It can also help you put details, very fine details, into your artwork that you may not be able to do without the use of another tool. So a stencil is a great tool to use in your artwork along with your airbrush. Stencils come in a variety of types. It may be a single layer that you just want to use as some background filler. It can be a single layer with multiple options, or it can be a multiple layer stencil. It all depends on what you're shopping for. On the other side is freehand shields. I use freehand shields all the time in my artwork. You can look at pretty much anything that I have ever painted, and I would be willing to bet that there's more than likely been a freehand shield used at some point. More often than not, a lot of points during the creation of that artwork. They are an amazing tool to have at your disposal for a variety of reasons. The freehand shield is not necessarily a stencil because it's not an image that you're going to paint on the canvas. A freehand shield, in my opinion, in my view, is a generic shape. It's something that you can use on just about anything. So that's the difference between a stencil versus a freehand shield for the purpose of this series of videos. I hope that makes sense. In the next segment, we're going to take a closer look at the stencils and how you can use the stencils for learning purposes, but I'll also talk about some of the reasons why I don't so much like purchasing store-bought stencils. So I hope you guys will follow along. I hope you get something out of this. If you do, remember to like, subscribe, and share. I'm Trevor with Wicked Art Studio. I'll see you guys next week.